Imagine waking up to a nuclear attack broadcast on your TV. Chaos, panic, confusion. But here's the kicker. It's completely fake. What if I told you it's possible for hackers to hijack your internet-based television, feeding you fake news broadcasts that look terrifying real? Hi. Today, I'll show you how I did just that on my own network. But don't worry, it was purely for research and raising awareness. The flaw lies in the heart of our TV system, a security loophole that could allow hackers to control what you see. No certificate check, no verification, just wide open access. This is how easy it is to hijack a TV broadcast, simulate an emergency, and create chaos. But this was not an accident. This was a demonstration to show how vulnerable our TV systems are. Stick around and I'll show you exactly how I was able to pull this off. To pull off this broadcast hijack, I used my unified dream machine to reroute traffic. This allowed me to redirect my TV's internet connection to a man-in-the-middle attack using my Ubuntu virtual machine. Let me break it down. I created dynamic routing entries on my router. This allowed me to reroute the traffic from my TV to my internal LAN and to a specific port in my virtual machine. My TV's traffic goes through my LAN and gets intercepted by my virtual machine. Traffic on port 443, usually used for secure connections, is forwarded to localhost on a specific port. This is where my Python proxy script comes in. Here's the crucial part. The problem is that the TV app isn't validating the server's SSL certificate. This means that when I redirect the traffic, my Python script issues a self-signed certificate that the TV simply accepts, no questions asked. The TV thinks it's still connected to the legitimate provider, but in reality, it's now connected to my custom-built MPEG-DASH broadcasting server. So now my server sends a fake emergency broadcast stream to the television, and the TV simply plays it. I created a video of a fake nuclear emergency and converted it to MPEG-DASH using FFmpeg. I even tested this on my own family. My wife and son were the guinea pigs, but given my reputation for pranks and tech shenanigans, they were suspicious from the start.
Speelt vandaag tegen de Australiër Scott Draper van Zandschulp. Twee het veld moeten ruimen. Titelverdediger Novak Djokovic verloor vooral.
Dit is een nooduitzending van de Nederlandse overheid. Er vindt op dit moment een nucleaire aanval plaats op Nederland en de Europese Unie. Dit is geen oefening. Zoek onmiddellijk beschutting. Ga direct naar binnen. Kies het dichtstbijzijnde gebouw. Vermijd ramen en buitenmuren. Als je buiten bent en geen gebouw kunt bereiken, zoek dan dekking achter een solide object of lig plat op de.
My wife didn't buy it for a second, but you can imagine the chaos this could cause on a large scale. Now imagine if this wasn't just me pulling a prank on my family, but a coordinated attack by hackers with malicious intent. Think Russian state hackers hijacking thousands of televisions with an emergency broadcast of a nuclear attack. Panic would spread like wildfire. All it takes is control over the DNS or router of the TV provider, and the hacker could hijack broadcast at scale. Due to missing certificate checks, the only thing standing between the hackers and the public is now just one fragile lock. This is a wake-up call for TV manufacturers and app developers. A simple certificate validation would prevent this type of attack. I followed responsible disclosure procedures and informed my TV provider of this vulnerability. It's essential that when vulnerabilities like this are discovered, they are reported properly so they can be fixed before a real disaster happens. So, this is why proper security checks in embedded systems matter. It's not just about securing your emails or your bank account. Vulnerabilities like this can cause mass panic and confusion, especially in the current geopolitical climate. If you are a developer, always implement certificate validation. And if you are watching this as a concerned viewer, remember, technology has made our world more connected, but also more vulnerable. Stay informed, stay safe, and share this video to spread awareness. Remember, don't try this at home unless it's your own network, and always disclose vulnerabilities responsibly. Let's work together to make our tech safer.